Are you looking for an excellent deal on travel? We've got you covered. In today's video, I'm sharing my top tips for how to get the best deal on your vacation. Welcome back. I hope you're all having a fantastic week. I'm Brianna at Travel Dolce, and today I am sharing my top five tips for getting the best deal on your vacation. So let's jump right in. So I'm starting off with my number one tip. This is always, always, always going to be my favorite tip for getting the best deal on travel, and that is to book early and know when to book. So the first part of that, booking early, is always going to give you the best options. It's going to give you the most availability, the most, that's when vendors have the most supply, is right when they put that out into the world. So that's when you're going to have the best opportunity to get exactly what you want on, resorts or airline tickets. You're going to be able to pick your seat. You're going to have the cream of the crop to pick from and not just the leftovers when they're trying to get rid of inventory. So aside from those last minute deals, when vendors are trying to dump inventory, booking early is always going to be your best bet. And typically by early, I mean at least 6 to 9 months in advance, and sometimes even earlier. It just depends on what you're looking at and when those vendors release the inventory. And the second part of that is knowing when to book. So if you're looking at airline tickets, if you book on Wednesdays from midnight to 1 a.m., that's going to be one of the best windows for booking those airline tickets where prices are the cheapest, or on Tuesday afternoons after 3 p.m. So a lot of times, the weekends are when people want to get this stuff done, but if you can book them during the week, if you're just booking an airline ticket separately, not as part of a package, you're going to get the best deal at that time. In addition, if you are flying on a Tuesday or Wednesday or a Saturday, those days are typically the cheapest days to fly. So if you're looking at your trip, going Saturday to Saturday can be good. Coming back on a Sunday, I know a lot of people like to do that, but that's going to cost you extra money. So, or if you can go midweek to midweek, like that Tuesday to Tuesday, that can end up saving you some big bucks as well. And flying on an actual holiday, surprisingly, will save you some big bucks too. Most of the time, people want to already be at their destination with family for holidays, but like if you're taking a family trip and like right after a holiday, maybe celebrate on Christmas Eve and then travel on the actual Christmas holiday, and you can save some serious cash. Tip number two is know when to travel. So like we just talked about, that Saturday to Saturday or even Wednesday to Wednesday would be even cheaper for plane travel. But also remember peak season. So if you're traveling during a shoulder season or a season that's just off the peak season, you're likely going to be able to save some money doing so. So for example, going to the Caribbean in February, where it's bitter cold in a lot of parts of the United States and Canada, that's going to be peak season. But if you can hold off until late March after the spring break crowds, or even April, that's what we call shoulder season. You get into that shoulder season period and you can save some money doing so. So just kind of keep that in mind. If you're dealing with anything that has like a typical peak season, that's going to be my best tip for that. And most things do. So even another example would be river cruises in Europe. So the peak time for river cruises is usually June through September, but prices are much lower during the off season, typically January to May. So my third tip is to get a rewards credit card and use loyalty programs. Be sure to get a good rewards credit card and rack up those points. There are several great ones out there, and many of them even have a sign-on bonus. So like if you spend $5,000 in the first 3 months, they'll give you 100,000 points or something like that. Just be aware of what your point like value is. So on some, like I'm currently using the Disney Visa card, and each point I earn is like $1. But on a lot of them, it's not like that. You earn points much more quickly, but points don't equal a dollar. So just kind of be aware of the value on those. Other cards I've heard great things about are the Chase Sapphire Rewards cards. Those have some of the best benefits. And also, I think we have an American Airlines Citi card, which also offers a great sign-on bonus right now and some great benefits. And I know a lot of people like the Southwest card as well. So if you fly Southwest a lot, that might be a good one. You can use it to purchase flights with those points. So just, I know there's lots out there and it pays to use them. If you're using more than one rewards credit card, pay attention to what categories you get double points for as well. So, like, some cards may give you double points for gas or grocery purchases or restaurant purchases. And I know some people will even actually write on their actual credit card with a Sharpie and say, you know, which card they should use for which category of purchase. You want to get the biggest return on your investment. So if it's stuff you're buying already anyways, you might as well earn points for it. And we even switched over some of our direct deposit bills over to the credit card. Now, we pay it off every single month, and I know that that can be kind of a pitfall for some people. I don't recommend carrying a balance from month to month on a credit card. So we always pay ours down to zero every single month, so we're not charged that interest. Because if you're being charged on top of your normal purchases you would make anyway, it's no longer a good deal. So just keep that in mind and pay attention to which categories you're earning the most points for. If you're curious to learn more about credit card points and how they work and all the ins and outs of it and all the inside secrets, I follow the points guy, and I'll put his website down in the description box below, but he has excellent information on how to use the points cards, which ones are the best, and if certain cards are running sign-on bonuses right now. So he has a great beginner article as well. So I'll go ahead and link that down in the description box below, but be sure and check out the points guy. And while we're on the topic of points, we should talk about the different hotel rewards programs. So like Marriott has the Bonvoy, Hilton has Hilton Honors, and I'm sure there's several others. But if you typically stay in a certain chain, it really pays to sign up for their loyalty programs. They offer things like discounted room rates for their members, a free night stay after so many night stays. So it really is awesome because it's free to sign up for most of them. So it just makes sense to join. Are any of you guys signed up for a loyalty rewards program? If so, drop it in the comments below. Like I said, we're currently using our Disney credit card for pretty much everything. We're trying to earn a discount for when we go to our next Disney trip. So we're trying to just put everything we can on that card and rack up as many points as possible. But we also do like Hilton Honors and the Marriott Bonvoy. We're not super loyal to any certain hotel chain, but it does make a difference if, you know, you're looking for a hotel room in a certain city. We try to pick the ones that we're already members of because we can usually get a discounted rate. And tip number four is to use a travel agent. So if you're going to a destination that you're unfamiliar with, this can be super beneficial. But even if you have been there before, it's good to check with a travel agent because we keep our pulse on all the latest deals and you know, refurbs or projects going on in certain areas that we sell. So we always have the most up-to-date information, and it may not be something that hotels like generally advertise on their websites if they're trying to sell you a product. Like, for example, the hurricane rebuild in the Bahamas, you know, they still need to sell their inventory and sell their product, especially during this time where they're rebuilding and don't have a ton of tourists coming. So just, I know that's kind of a vague example because most everyone knows about the hurricane that hit the Bahamas this last hurricane season, but just things like that. Even Disney, like what rides are going to be down. The water ride refurbishment typically happens in January and February each year. You know, check with your travel agent. We know also a lot of the pools at Disney and the value resorts are getting refurbed right now. Those are things that we see every day. They come to our email. We have access to that information very easily. So we can kind of steer you in the right direction and help you pick the best best location and get the best bang for your buck. Even after you book your vacation, a travel agent will also keep an eye out for discounts that can be applied after booking. So this is true at Disney World up until a month before you travel and your final payment is due. You can go ahead and apply discounts and deals that Disney releases. Now, they are subject to availability, so usually there is only a certain number of rooms at each hotel that will qualify for the deal, but we'll keep an eye out for those deals, and we know that they're always released on Tuesdays. So Tuesdays, we log into our email early and make sure that we aren't missing any of the deals that could be applied to our customers' reservations that have already been booked. And tip number five, my last tip for this video, is to be flexible and book when there are sales. Being flexible with your travel dates, airlines you use, resorts you stay at can really help you come out ahead. If you're not super particular and book when those sales are rolled out, it can really save you a lot of money. But be sure and act quickly if you are trying to get in for a sale rate. Some sales, they will like have a date range, but other sales, just a certain number of rooms are allotted from that vendor or a certain number of airline tickets for that flight. So just be sure, you know, once those fill up, the sale is going to be over. So be sure and act quickly to be able to get in on that deal and get the most bang for your buck. So pay attention, sign up for those emails, and act quickly when you see the sale first roll out. Also, by booking right when that sale rolls out, you're going to get the pick of the inventory. And if they have a certain number of room types, you know, at each level, and you want a specific one, booking early in that sale is going to guarantee you your best option for getting that. So I've got a couple bonus tips for you. So if you're booking everything separately, like not in a bundle, so if you're doing like a hotel room, a rental car, and a flight, typically I recommend that it will save you money to bundle. But sometimes if you're doing it just separately or kind of on the fly, if you add things to your cart but then don't complete the transaction, you want to be sure you enter your email address though, because sometimes vendors will send you an email then like with a coupon, so you'll seal the deal with them, so you'll go ahead and book. So even if it's only 10%, it's better than nothing, and give it a try. Let me know how it goes. And my bonus tip number two is to use Rakuten. This used to be called Ebates, but basically what it is internet extension, internet browser extension. So you just add it to your internet browser, and it will, for any website that you shop at, like Gap or whatever it is, anything that you shop at, it will search and see if they offer a cash back. And then all you have to do is click the button for cash back. It'll open a shopping trip, and you just shop on their website just like you normally would, and it will give you cash back. So a big purchase like a vacation, even if you're getting a low percentage of cash back, that can really pay off, because I think it's at the end of every month they'll go ahead and send you a check in the mail for whatever percentage of cash back that you earned for that month. So I use this all the time. Anytime I shop online, which is often, probably more often than I should, but it really does save money, and it really does work. So they send you your check for cash back at the end of the month, and then I always just deposit it in our bank account, and it works really slick. Okay guys, that's it for today. If you found this information valuable, please go ahead and subscribe below. I really appreciate your support. And if you ring that notification bell, you'll be notified every time I upload a video. I upload new videos every single Thursday at 10 a.m. So I'd love to see you here for the next one. Hope you guys have a great week. Bye.